For the last couple of years, South Korea has been plagued by a distasteful trend: cyber wreckers. They are individuals who profit from the enormous circulation of maliciously edited rumors or bad news pertaining to celebrities. As the name, cyber wrecker, implies, they are akin to private tow trucks that continue to abuse emergency lights and sirens without being state approved. They thrive on the destruction of celebrities' lives by leaking their personal information to the public for monetary satisfaction. Just recently, popular YouTuber Tzuyang fell victim to a case that showed everybody just how bad these wrongdoings could get. The cyber wreckers typically act with the pseudonymity that the internet gives them and persist in their campaign of producing and circulating defamatory content to generate views and advertising revenue. This form of digital harassment isn't new, but the impact has gone up manifold with the times at the might of social media platforms like YouTube, Instagram, and Twitter. Recently, a woman YouTuber with the English name Tzuyang exposed that she was physically and financially abused by her ex-boyfriend over the course of 4 years. He further coerced her to work in bars and took almost all the money she made from the channel, upwards of 4 billion won in 4 years, and blackmailed her by saying he would release secretly filmed videos of her. It was then alleged that, after all the recent revelations, a group of YouTubers blackmailed Tzuyang over her past and demanded money to keep quiet. Released was a recording where YouTuber Gu Jae Yook, whose real name is Lee Joon Hee, blackmailed Tzuyang. Fellow YouTubers Caracula and John Gukjin were implicated in the scheme. One can hear Lee in the recording talking to the other two on how to cash in on Tzuyang's painful past. He admitted Tzuyang had given him 11 million won, or $8,000, for keeping mum, and that the others had told him to press her for more money. Given that her channel is very profitable, it was advised that better Tzuyang pays them off than them releasing a very damaging video about her past. Only a dozen South Korean channels have hit more than 10 million subscribers, topped by Tzuyang's channel. While Lee and Caracula have denied the allegations, John has remained mum. Lee said he would explain himself in upcoming videos, while Caracula said he would refute it. Tzuyang had just been released from the control of her ex-boyfriend, whose attorneys had turned in several criminal charges to the police against him, including violations of sex crime laws, assault, intimidation, and blackmail. He killed himself in the course of the investigation, and so the case was closed. He admitted that he wanted to respect the wishes of Tzuyang's family to forget her dark past, but he and other cyber wreckers were notorious for sensationalizing unverified rumors about celebrities. Caracula recently made news for saying that the ex-girlfriend of basketball star Hyeong had worked at a high-profile bar when in real life, she was actually trying to distance herself from suspicion of being a working girl at a hostess bar. Activities of cyber wreckers do not only affect their targets, but also the general public's perception of privacy and trust on the internet. British singer Adele has been on the receiving end of a number of false claims regarding her personal life, including her love life and health condition. Photo and private information leaks associated with the Hollywood star Scarlett Johansson have been carried out by cyber wreckers without her consent. This has caused her immense psychological trauma and several lawsuits. A number of cyber wreckers claim to protect the public's right to know the truth. For example, Caracula, based in Busan, went public in 2002 with the identity of the man who had tried to rape and kill his victim. Numerous channels brought to light the people involved in the 2004 Miryeong gang rape case who escaped criminal penalty due to being minors at the time. This vigilante mindset has been widely deplored, however, and many adverse effects have arisen from it. Of the many videos about the Miryeong incident, at least one misidentified a woman living in the area as a girlfriend of a sex criminal. She was victimized by cyberbullying. There are conspicuous and intentional editing of videos about celebrities to create clickbait content by some cyber wreckers. A former YouTuber whose surname is Park was indicted in May for the defamation of some K-pop stars, while the Incheon District Court froze her assets and plans to seize them if found to be profits from illegal activities. She spread groundless rumors related to K-pop stars, such as dating rumors or plastic surgery claims, garnering 160 million views before her channel was shut down last June. It has been hard for local entertainment agencies to sue anonymous YouTubers like Park because of the law that requires filing information on the defendant to be disclosed. Google, which operates YouTube, is based in California, and requesting a court order to disclose information on the channel hosts requires a court order from California. The U.S. District Court of California ruled that K-pop star Jang Wonyoung's agency, Starship Entertainment Co., may have the right to request information from Google and YouTube. The company filed a lawsuit in the District Court for the Northern District of California last year. Later, other agencies, including NewJeans agency, Audair, were to apply for the same court orders to request details of the cyber wreckers behind the malicious posts about their artists. As the cyber wreckers problem is increasing gradually day by day, there is an instant need for more stringent regulations and international cooperation to safeguard the public from this exploitation. Social media itself also has some responsibility to develop and implement stricter policies and technologies to quickly identify and remove such malicious content. The serious psychological effects of this fall upon the victims of cyber wreckers. Many a time, the victims who become the target of such vicious campaign at times give in to anxiety and depression with massive invasion of personal privacy. The continuous feeling of being exposed and manipulated in their private life may at times lead to mental illness. Less obviously, cyber wreckers contribute to a culture of fear and mistrust online. With increased awareness about the possible view of digital harassment, more people will become reluctant to share personal information or engage with the social media platforms at all. This changes the dynamics of online communities. In the face of this threat from cyber wreckers, a number of technological solutions are underway. Artificial intelligence and machine learning can efficiently detect and flag off offending content. Big social media platforms are also investing in better moderation tools and user reporting systems to address issues quickly. However, what is needed is not the technology alone, but rather thorough education and sensitization of issues. Not only has the public got to be educated about the risks associated with cyber harassment, but also about digital literacy. If people are aware of how their online presence can be best protected and how to identify maltreatment, then we can begin to foster a safer, more respectful online environment. With cyber wreckers now a growing problem, investigative interest has been drawn to it. One of the investigative teams works at dirtyfiles, and this channel is concerned about highlighting such important issues, unveiling the truth, and giving a platform to the victims. We sure are for keeping a close eye on any development in the Tzuyang case and bringing the latest updates to our viewers. Everybody worried about what's happening in this continued fight against cyber wreckers and other associated issues, please like dirtyfiles. We will delve deeper into real crime, unsolved mysteries, criminal cases, and more. Share and help get the word out. Comment below on joining our community to become vigilant on matters concerning cyber harassment and exploitation.